This is part two of simplifying complex fractions. In part one, we went over method when. Here's a reminder of how to do method when. We simplify the numerator and denominator of the complex fraction, so each is a single fraction, and then we multiply the fraction in the numerator of that complex fraction by the reciprocal of the fraction in the denominator of that complex fraction, and then we simplified. At the end of part one, I introduced another method, and we worked one of the problems we did using method one using a new method, which I'll call method two. In this method, we multiply the numerator and denominator of the complex fraction by the least common denominator of the fractions in both the numerator and denominator, then simplify. Okay, that's kind of a mouthful, but if we actually work some problems, we'll see this isn't so bad. All right, here's an example of a complex fraction, and we want to simplify it. Remember, a complex fraction has a fraction either in the numerator, the denominator, or in both, as it does in this case. Method 2 is especially useful if you don't have a single fraction in the numerator and a single fraction in the denominator. So like there's some plus signs up here in the numerator or denominator. So what's the LCD? Method 2 says find the LCD of all the denominators. So we've got like for all the denominators there's an x squared, x, an x squared, an x. The least common denominator is simply x squared. So we want to multiply the numerator and the denominator of this big complex fraction by the least common denominator, which is just x squared over x squared. So we're multiplying the numerator by x squared, the denominator by x squared. That'll make an equivalent fraction because you're multiplying the numerator and denominator by the same thing. All right, so you have to distribute. So we've got in the big numerator here, x squared times 2 over x squared. So let's write that out. X squared times 2 over x squared plus, distributing, I've got x squared times 1 over x. Now if you want, you could write x squared over 1, those of you that like to see it written as a fraction. All right, I've done the numerator by x squared. Now I'm going to do the denominator by x squared. Same reasoning. I'm going to write that as x squared over 1 times 4 over x squared minus, distributing, x squared over 1 times 1 over x. Now what's great about this method, you immediately get rid of any of the fractions in the numerator and the denominator because things will cancel. So my x squares cancel here. Now what happens over here? I've got x squared over x. That's going to cancel to just give me 1x in the numerator, knowing your laws of exponents, right? We've got an x squared over x squared here. Those are going to cancel. And let's see, x squared over x here, that'll give me just 1x in the numerator. So look what happens to my numerator. What I'm left with is just 2 over 1, which is 2, plus just an x. And in the denominator, I've got just a 4 minus an x. And those can't be, neither of those can be factored, so that you're not going to be able to cancel. We're done. That's it. Now you could have done this problem using method 1 as well. You would have to get a common denominator in the numerator, add the fractions, get a common denominator in the denominator, add the fractions. Then you'd have to multiply by the reciprocal and you should end up with the same result. So you could, why don't you put this on pause and see if you could do method 1 and then I'll show the steps. All right, let's do this using method 1. The numerator, I need a common denominator so I could add the fractions, so I'll have to multiply this second fraction by x over x so that I have the same denominator as I have for the first fraction here, so they're going to both be x squareds, and in the denominator also just happens to be x squared. That might not happen, in fact, usually it doesn't. But in this case, that's how it was written. So what do I have in the numerator? I've got a common denominator of x squared, so I could add the numerators 2 plus x. Now the denominator, all right, I'm going to have x squared for the denominator, and in the numerator I'll have 4 minus x. All right, so I've written it as a single fraction in the numerator, a single fraction in the denominator. So the next step is to take the numerator, which is 2 plus x over x squared, and multiply it by the reciprocal of what's in the denominator. So remember, we're taking the reciprocal of this, right? So we're going to multiply it by x squared over 4 minus x. The x squares cancel, and we end up exactly with the same answer we did using method one. Both methods are completely valid. You just have to make sure you do them correctly. Let's try this one. 3 over x plus 2 plus 5 over x minus 2 all over 4 over x squared minus 4. So you would need to determine the least common denominator of all these denominators if you were going to use method 2. And hopefully you'll realize that x plus 2 times x minus 2 actually equals x squared minus 4. So x squared minus 4 is your least common denominator, but you might want to rewrite this x squared minus 4 as x plus 2 times x minus 2 when you actually do the multiplication. So I'm going to move this over here. All right, so let's do this. I'm going to take the whole numerator and the whole denominator, and we're going to multiply it by x squared minus 4. Now, remember, you can write x squared minus 4 as x plus 2 times x minus 2, right? Either way is fine. But that might help you in this to break it up into its factors. So now I'm going to multiply through using the distributive property. So in the numerator here, hopefully you can see what's going to happen. Let's see if we could do this without writing out all the steps. When you multiply this x plus 2 times x minus 2 times the first term here, the x plus 2's will cancel, and you'll only have 3 times the x minus 2. Can you see how that works? Because if you wrote the x plus 2 in the numerator here and the x plus 2, they're just going to cancel. Plus, all right, let's do that. Now, when you multiply it by the second fraction, do you see how the x minus 2's will cancel? So you'll only have 5 times x plus 2. So you see how that eliminated all the fractions? And in the denominator, what happens? When you multiply this x plus 2 times x minus 2, it's going to cancel with x squared minus 4 because that's exactly the same as x squared minus 4. So you just end up with a 4 in the denominator. So all we need to do is simplify this numerator. So we're going to have to do the distributive property, 3x minus 6 plus 5x plus 10 all over 4. You with me? And then let's add like terms. We have 8x plus 4 all over 4. All right, then what do? You want to factor to see if anything reduces. So let's factor a 4 out of the numerator. And wow, that cancels with that 4. Remember, that's like ones if you want to write those down. So what's the final answer? All of this ends up just equaling 2x plus 1. So wow, that original complex fraction is a complicated way of writing 2x plus 1. So the answer is 2x plus 1. This can also be done using the second method where you get a common denominator in the numerator up here, the numerator of the complex fraction, and get a single fraction first. And then you could multiply by the reciprocal, you get exactly the same answer. My suggestion is if you have like an addition problem with fractions up in the numerator denominator, this second method is usually easier. If you already have a single fraction in the numerator or denominator, then usually it's just as easy to go ahead and multiply by the reciprocal. Let's do one more. Let's end with one easy one. Okay, this has a single fraction in the numerator and denominator, so you can just take the numerator, multiply it by the reciprocal of the denominator. And that's pretty easy, right? Because it already had single fractions, 5 over 6. Now let's just do method 2. What's the least common denominators? Well, you've got a 4 in the denominator down here and an 8, so the least common denominator is 8. So I'm just going to multiply the numerator by 8 and the denominator by 8. And let's see, the 8s cancel here, so we have a 5. And in the denominator, we have 2 times 3 is 6. Notice I get the same answer. Both methods work. This was just on a simple arithmetic problem, but the same is true for algebra.